Over the course of our last videos, we shared with you how to create some fancy visual effects, including applying digital makeup, creating a freeze effect, or how to create your own color template with tracking. We then showed you how to save these effects as templates so you could use them in future projects or share them with other creators. Well, today's video is very much a natural continuity as Blackmagic Design just released a really handy feature with a 17.2 update of DaVinci Resolve. It is now possible to create DRFX files to bundle together your effects and organize them in a neat installable package. The best part? It's super easy. Let's get started. As usual, we want to thank everyone that joined the channel, and if you haven't subscribed already, think about doing so. Because we believe it is much more interesting to have a practical approach to learning, we are going to go through the whole process of creating an effect. From creating a pretty subscribe element for your YouTube videos, to bundling it into a DRFX file. We'll even see how to create custom icons for your effects so they look all fancy in the effects library. But if you are only interested about the DRFX part of this video, feel free to use the chapters in the description down below and skip to this part of the tutorial. Let's jump into Fusion. To create our effect, we need to add a new Fusion composition. Go to the media pool, right click, select new Fusion composition, give it a name, and double click on it to open it. Because we are working on a blank Fusion composition rather than on a clip, we only have a media out by default. And actually, we can delete it because we won't need it. Let's start by adding the base elements of our template. We need one input, one background, and one output. For the input, we'll use a merge node and a background that will be connecting together. For the output, we'll use a transform node that will also let us manipulate our effects later on. It is good practice to rename some of your nodes, particularly when dealing with templates. Select a node, press F2 and give them names that give an ID for what they are for. Next, we need to create the shape. And for that, we'll be using a rectangle and the background node. We could use something a little more exotic like DaVinci Resolve 17 shape tools, but as we want to keep this simple and straightforward, we'll keep that for another dedicated tutorial. Gonna make some space, add a rectangle, a background, connect them together, and connect the background output to the output of the main background. This will automatically create a merge node to connect it. We're gonna drag the output to the window, shape the rectangle to your liking, adjust the size, the corners, and change the color in the background node. I'm gonna pick four corners and I'll change the top left and right for some shade of red. There, a bit darker. Time to add our YouTube logo. This comes directly from YouTube Brand Resources webpage, and you will find a direct link to download it in the description down below. To import our icon, we'll use a loader. Tap Ctrl Space or Shift Space, Loader, and here, pick the folder where you downloaded the icon. Let's clean it up. It's very important to keep your nodes while in order. And as we need to manipulate the icon, we're going to add a transform node to it. Drag it, press Shift, pass on the line, and drop. Now we're going to adjust both the icon and the rectangle, and adjust until we're satisfied. Let's add a text node and connect it to the merge output. Format it. Pick a font and place your text properly. Okay, time to add some flair by changing the operator mode for both merge 3 and merge 2 to XOR. And now we're going to add a drop shadow just after our merge 3 node. Select it, draw space, drop. Okay. And here, change the settings to get the effect that you want. And that's pretty cool. Actually, we're going to apply a small modification to our nodes, otherwise the drop shadow will be an issue later on. Press Shift, drag our merge input, and bring it on the line after the drop shadow. There we are, we're gonna rearrange this. And we're going to need a new transform node after the drop shadow. Now we'll be able to make sure that any clip that is fed inside the merge node won't be interfering with the effect. Now that we're done with our effect, let's make a template out of it. And if you're not familiar with how to create templates, we have a dedicated tutorial in our previous video, so you might want to check it. Type Ctrl or Command A to select all your nodes, right click, go to macro, create macro, and here select all parameters that you want to be able to access in the inspector. Very important, make sure that you select background for your input node. Select file, save as, and choose a folder easily accessible. Save, press this. Before we go on creating the DRFX file, I want to show you how to create a custom icon for your FX library. Let's select transform and resize the effect to fill up the window. Right click on the viewer and select save image. Save it as a PNG with exactly the same name as your settings file. Now, you need to resize this image with your favorite editing software. We're using Photoshop, but you can even use the one integrated to Windows. Let's open it. Click resize, custom dimension, 104 by 58. And replace the original. Okay, for the last part of our tutorial, let's see how to create and install a DRFX bundle. The DRFX file is actually nothing more than a zip archive with the extension changed from zip to DRFX. It allows us to use the same directory structure as the one in Fusion. Use any of the folders in Edit or Fusion to place your effects, and DaVinci Resolve will sort them neatly in matching categories. After creating the folders that fit your need, grab the two files that we created, both settings and the PNG, and place them in Edit and Effects. Perfect. Go back to the root folder, and we will now add those folders to a zip archive. We're using the free software 7-zip to create our archive, and actually, we noticed some weird behavior in the Edit page where effects were missing while being in the Fusion page when using the built-in compressor from Windows. Let us know in the comment if that happened to you. Name it whatever you want, and change the extension from zip to DRFX. Confirm. Now, how do we import it back into Fusion? You'll see, it's actually very simple. Drag your DRFX file and drop it into the nodes window. DaVinci Resolve will ask you if you want to install it in the FX library. By installing, they mean that Fusion will simply copy this archive and place it into the DaVinci Resolve user folder. Nothing's actually installed, and Fusion will directly access the archive and its content. And after restarting DaVinci Resolve, you'll be able to find your effect in the edit page as well, in the effect library, and we can see here this pretty icon. I'm gonna add it to our clip. Go to Effect tab, and here I can change the size. I can even activate the Fusion overlay to manipulate it directly. If you need to remove one or all the effects that you added with the DRFX file, you will need to either overwrite or delete the archive. You can go to Fusion, right click on Templates, click Show Folder. You can either delete the file, or if you have software installed like 7-zip, open as an archive, and inside you can now modify anything you want. Add, remove, or just edit. If you have some question or feedback about today's video, please leave us a comment. If you enjoyed this video, leave a thumbs up, and don't forget to check our playlist about DaVinci Resolve and VFX. And we'll see you in the next video. Peace!